Sitting through the leadership courses, I was reminded how much we have done in the world of all-star cheer and dance and getting the routines ready, getting the competitions ready, and putting on a great show for the spectators. But we haven't spent as much time focusing on those leadership attributes. And a lot of that stuff we focused on when we were coming up in the sport, but we haven't focused on it as much with today's athletes.
I agree with you. I think that the opportunity to develop leaders in this sport has been missed for a few years. Like you talked about, we grew up seeing those things and getting those values. And leadership programs like the one we saw this weekend was a breath of fresh air, because the kids from different programs were not in a competitive environment, and they were all being able to vibe off of each other and offer encouragement in an environment that I don't think exists in our competitive environment. And that was a big cultural thing that I think we need to change in our industry.
It was really impactful, and I thought that the coaches in the program, I thought they could really glean and get a lot from it. I mean, I think, as Justin said, in this day and age, you know, coaches don't necessarily go through NCA or any other type of company for, you know, leadership training. I think the leadership training that was provided, you know, through this program was awesome, because, you know, our coaches need to embrace leadership. You know, when the leader's better, the team is better. When the leader's better, the program's better. When the leader's better, the industry is going to be better. Just like Justin said, I think, you know, it's time for more of an emphasis on those aspects of leadership to pass down to our athletes.
Yeah, and I thought it was really, really cool from the athlete perspective, the way the athletes had all these aha moments about who they were as leaders, like what it means to like really give back to their teams, to their gyms, to their studios, and the way that they took the time to really get to know who they were as people and how who they were as people translated to who they were as a leader, so that they can go out to their schools, to their gyms, to their studios, really in life, and multiply the things that they learned and apply them wherever they go.
You know what my favorite part was? Of all the classes we sat in, it was the very beginning when the athletes learned how to walk up and shake our hands and look us in the eye and tell us their names.
Absolutely.
And you can tell there were some athletes that had been trained, they had been worked on with their coaches or with their parents, and there were some that were learning for the first time what it means to maintain eye contact, things that are so important in this world, well beyond cheerleading and dance.
And just like what you just said, I found it to be a challenge to go through that exercise as well. And it was cool because in order, like what you're saying, that the leaders need to become leaders and push that, that was a leadership quality in myself that I had not honed in, I had not worked out. And so to be able to do that with the athletes this morning was very empowering, and gave me a skill set that I'll be able to take back to the gym and encourage other people to do, and by my example, hopefully they'll be able to show that same type of professionalism.
Yeah, and I think to tie what both of you said together, like the USASF leadership programs, all of them, whether it's the adults or the athletes, really are trying to get you to step outside of your comfort zone. I know when we did the activities and then seeing the kids and then seeing the coaches and the owners and everyone, it really just forced you to step outside of what your normal everyday like level of comfort was.
Sure.
The season is jam-packed these days. There are so many routines to get choreographed, practices that have to get done, an endless amount of competitions. It's so nice to take a deep breath over the summer and focus on something other than cheer and dance, something that's going to help them be successful after they're done with their cheer and dance career.
Sure. And I believe that after their cheer and dance career will be the bigger challenges. You know, they are using these tools and they're learning these tools through the USASF leadership program to take back to gyms and take back to their cheer or dance team. But the lessons that are being taught to them will be tools that they'll be able to take way past and become, again, a guiding light to the world that's around them outside of the all-star environment.
Absolutely.